EIT is electrical impedance tomography, and it is a way to image the chest without radiation, without sedation, and in real time.
What you're doing in EIT is you're flowing very, very small currents into the body. And so you have this band of electrodes. You decide what plane or what slice you want to look at. And that's the row where you're going to put this belt onto the person. And then from there, the electricity slowly flows in and we measure the voltage. So you're putting current into the body. Your tissues are resisting the flow of the current. So then what you measure are the potentials at the plane. And this particular measurement of the electrical potentials is what we use then to create the map that shows us the different electrical properties inside the body. Because air doesn't like to conduct electricity, makes it actually really easy for us to detect regions where maybe air is trapped or you're not getting good ventilation.
So we get not only a picture of the structure of the lung like we would on chest CT, but we also get that airflow and blood movement, so we get a function of what's happening.
In this device, you're trying to balance sort of what makes the device work the best. People are excellent antennas, and there's an electrical potential that exists between me and all of the electronics in this room. And so there's this interference that you can pick up. The mathematicians are concerned about how do we reduce the effects of those things on the quality of our data. Where the people using your device in the clinic want to know, how can I get this device on quickly? Is this device easy to clean? As a biomedical engineer, you're trying to find this balance of how can I design something where the data is good enough for the mathematicians, but also the device itself is going to be usable for the clinicians.
Lung function is one of the most important things that we make our decisions on. And we found that the EIT images gave us the information that the CT scan gave us and the information that the lung function measurements gave us. If we had that information on every patient and we knew exactly how to treat you to get both of your lungs at their maximum health and matching the blood flow, I think it could help all of the preemies, all our patients with BPD, the neuromuscular weakness. We can really target our treatment so that we're maximizing your lung function and we're seeing that happen in real time.